गुड मॉर्निंग सेवेंथ क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल इन स्टडिंग एज वेल. स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर 6, लर्न टू यूज एडोब फ्लैश प्रोफेशनल 6. इन दिस बाय नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड वन वीडियो, सो क्विकली आई विल हैव अ रिकैप ऑफ दैट वीडियो एंड देन वी विल मूव अहेड. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू इट्स लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू वर्क इन दिस एडोब फ्लैश प्रोफेशनल CS6, what you have to do, first you have to install this software on your system, on your computer, only then you can work in it. Okay, so let's start with the recap session, then we will move ahead. So what we did by now in this, first we learned about the introduction, Adobe Professional CS6. I told you what is Adobe Professional CS6. It's a software which is used for creating animation, games, cartoons, text, graphics, etc. Then how to start it? Suppose this software is already installed on your computer, then how we can start it? We will go to start button, then we will go to all programs, then Adobe option, then Adobe Flash Professional CS6 you will click, and this way a window will appear. In that window I explained you various component of a flash window, like where is menu bar, timeline panel, tools panel, stage, then work area, where do we work, this is called work area, then property inspector. These all are what? These are the components of the flash interface, or we can say these are the components of the flash window. What are the components? Just recall it again. First is menu bar, where the menu or the commands are available. Then stage is the white rectangular area. Then work area, where do we work, or the area around the stage is called work area. Then property inspector, it is used to organize and modify the properties of the current selection. Then timeline panel, it organizes and controls the file contained over in layers and frames. Then tools panel, it is used to choose different tools. Color palette is also there for different colors. Then I told you who is the developer, who is the main programmer and the visionary of Flash software. Jonathan Gay is the main visionary behind the Flash software. Then how to save a Flash file, that also we did. So it's very much like other files, like when we are making a file in Paint, or we are making a file in MS Word, or we are making a file in PowerPoint. So the way we save those files, similarly we can save a Flash file also by clicking on file menu, then by clicking on save we can save a Flash file. Then opening a Flash file, how we can open, that method is also same like other files. We will go to file menu, then we will click on open, and that file will be opened. Now exiting flash means leaving flash or closing flash. So how that we can do that, we will go to file menu, then we will click on exit option, and we will come out of flash. Okay, next was flash tools panel. Flash tools panel means how many tools are there in this flash tools. We did about all these tools. These tools have been given here on screen right now. Some of the tools are very much similar, just like your paint, like all of you have done paint. So in paint you are using tools, so in that also similar tools we are having, like we are also having text tool in paint, we are having pencil, eraser, these tools we are having in paint if you have done. So similarly we are having some more tools in this. Okay, so let's do these tools one by one. This is our today's topic. Property inspector also I told you. Property inspector, like suppose if you are working on one tool, like suppose if you are working on pencil, so all the properties relating to that pencil will be shown in property inspector. So property inspector can have like stroke color. Stroke color is what? It is the outline color of the object. Okay, suppose if you were drawing a rectangle, then outline color of the rectangle will be called the stroke color. And fill color is the color inside the object. Like rectangle you made, so the stroke color was the outline color of the rectangle, and fill color was the color inside the rectangle. Then stroke style. Stroke styles are given here, like you can give a dash line, you can give a thick line, you can give a thin line, you can give dot dot dot. So these are what? These are stroke styles. Okay, then stroke size and stroke height. Means stroke size and stroke height means it is the width of the stroke. Width of the stroke, here you can see, if we will move this slider, the width and the height of the stroke is increased. Means that stroke that you are drawing, that will become thick. Okay, now using the flash tool, the first tool which is there in the flash is line tool. As the name is, line tool, it should be used to make lines only, and using lines we can make various figures. So here line tool is used to draw the lines on the stage. We can change the stroke color, we can change the stroke style, stroke size that we have just seen. Okay, so when we have taken this line tool, here in the property inspector, here you can say property inspector, we can set the properties of this line tool, and we can work according to the those properties. Like we can have a stroke color, we can have fill color different, or in this way we can work with that. Now to draw a line at 45 degree increment, hold down the shift key while dragging. Means if you want to draw a line at 45 degree increment, then what you have to do, you have to hold the shift key on your keyboard. Okay, so let's move ahead in this. What is next? Next is pencil tool. So everybody is aware with pencil tool. Pencil tool is there in MS Word also. MS Paint also. So pencil tool, it works just like pencil only. So we will use the pencil mode. We can select the pencil mode in this by going again in the property inspector, which will be displayed here. So by using pencil tool, you can draw free from drawings. Free from drawings means when we were using line tool, we were able to draw straight lines only. But if we are using pencil, we can draw anything. Like we have drawn a flower over here. Okay, we can draw a butterfly. We can draw something else. Okay, so free from drawing when we want to do, then we will use pencil. And next is rectangle tool. So rectangle tool is used to draw rectangles. So to draw a rectangle, we have to follow these steps. Like we will select this tool first. Then we will come to the work area, then we will draw it. We will drag the mouse on the stage and then we will draw it. And before drawing, if we want to set the stroke color, stroke style, fill color, fill and stroke section in the inspector window are given over here. So we can select those properties, and after selecting we can draw it. See, you can see over here they have drawn a rectangle which is of blue color. In this they have selected fill color as blue, so that's why blue color is coming. Okay, so you can also draw other shapes like oval, polystar, etc. on the stage. Click the small arrow on the rectangle tool and choose the tool you want. Means when you are on the rectangle tool here in the toolbox, so if you will go to right, a small arrow will come. If you will now move your pointer towards that small arrow, then you can see other options in this rectangle tool only. And what are those other options? These are like oval shape, polystar, etc. Like you will find many shapes over there when you will move your pointer over there. The next tool is brush tool. Brush tool also we have used in paint. It's very much like brush that you are using in drawing. So what does this do? We in this also, like we can select the size and shape of brush. After selecting that size and shape in property inspector, we can draw with the help of brush tool. Now what is the difference between pencil and brush? What is the difference? When we want to draw thick lines, then we will be using brush tool basically. Okay, that you can see over here they have drawn a tree. So this tree is drawn with thick lines, so this is done with the help of brush tool. Now next is paint bucket tool. Now what is the use of paint bucket tool? Paint bucket tool is used to fill object with color. Means ऑब्जेक्ट्स में जब भी हमें कलर करना है, जैसे हम पेंट में यूज करते थे तो एक बकेट शो होता था. सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो वी आर हैविंग अ बकेट विच इज कॉल्ड पेंट बकेट. सो वी विल क्लिक ऑन दैट बकेट एंड वी कैन सेलेक्ट द फिल एंड स्ट्रोक सेक्शन. देन वी विल क्लिक ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट वेयर वी वॉन्ट टू फिल दैट कलर. यू कैन सी ओवर हेयर अ नाइस फ्लावर वॉज ड्रॉन. देन वी डिड द यूज द पेंट बकेट कलर एंड कलर हैज बीन filled in this. Okay, here is color palette. You can change the colors accordingly by selecting in the color palette. Now next is eraser tool, everybody's favorite eraser. Why do we use eraser in real life? Why do we use eraser? We use eraser to erase things. So similarly in flash also we are having this tool to erase, like something we have drawn that we didn't want, by mistake we draw something on stage, so now we want to erase it. So how we will do it? We will do it with the help of eraser tool. You can see over here, they just like there on the screen, a tree is drawn. Then by using the eraser tool, this tree has been erased partially. The next is text tool. Now what is the use of text tool? Text tool as in text. What means text? Text means characters. Like suppose if you want to write your name, then what will you use? You will use text tool. So text tool is used to type text on the stage. Text tool is used to type text on the stage. Yes, text tool, as I told you, it is used to draw, it is used to write text. Okay, so when we want to write text, what we will use? We will use text tool. Like suppose here they have written keep smiling. So if you want to write keep smiling, which tool will be used? Text tool will be used. Now next is selection tool. Now selection tool is also there in paint. Why I am comparing it with paint every time? I am comparing it with paint because all of you have done paint a lot and it's quite easy, you enjoy it, so that you can easily understand it. Moreover, if you want to see the tools again, you want to see those tools, then you can open paint and you can see what this tool does, so you will understand the working of these tools also. Okay, then selection tool is used to select anything drawn on the stage. So there are two commonly used selection tools in flash. Selection pointer tool, it selects rectangular shape area. Then lasso tool selects irregular shapes areas of drawing. Then drawing a curve, suppose if we want to draw a curve, then we can change a straight line into a curve using the selection tool. Okay, how we will do that? First we will click on the line tool, we will draw the line, then using the selection tool we will drag it, and as we will drag the line, what will happen? It will come in the shape of a bow or it will become a curve. Okay, the next is free transform tool. Now free transform tool, it is used to scale, rotate or distort. Scale means to stretch something. If you are stretching something like rubber band, elastic, you stretch them, so that is called scaling. So if you want to stretch a picture, if you want to distort means press, compress or stretch from one side only, and if you want to rotate or skew a picture, so all these options can be done with the help of free transform tool. You can see how they have done. See, they have shown here in the figure, this is rotate, this was a rectangle, then it has been rotate. Okay, rotate and skew. Okay, rotating and skew means to change the angle of the picture. Then scale, it has been made small. Okay, then distort means changing the shape. Then envelope. These are the shapes that we can do using the free transform tool. Now we are moving to next topic, which is grouping objects. Now grouping objects and shapes. Grouping means to combine the basic shapes, objects together as one. For example, to design a car, we use various shapes. However, all these shapes need to grouped as one for the complete car to be formed. So to group objects, there are steps how to group them. This grouping option is also there in MS Word, and we have done it in the previous classes. Those who want to try it on MS Word, they can do it. In that also, what we do, like we have drawn 2-3 pictures, and we select all these pictures under the one group. Okay, so what are the steps? Draw the shapes, select all of them using selection tool, then click the modify menu and then click on group option. This way all these objects will be treated as one. How they will be treated as one means, like suppose there were 2-3 pictures, one was circle, one was rectangle, one was like smiley, and you grouped all those objects as one. So when you will be moving, they all will be moving together from one place to, like suppose you are moving from them from center to corner of the page. So when grouping is done, they will move together. Okay, then more fun in lab is given, like it's how you can work with this grouping objects and all. As I told you, you can try this grouping with MS Word without installing this MS, without installing Flash. So even if Flash is not there, you can try many tools on Paint and this grouping and ungrouping option in Word. Now what were the key points that we have done in this chapter? First, we studied about Adobe Flash Professional CS6. It's a software which is used to create animations. What are animations? When we are giving moving effect to our pictures or to our images, that is called animation. Animation basically life. Life is always movable. Okay, when something is having life, that person moves. Okay, so animation has come from there only. Animation means giving movement to the objects. Then you can create, open, save and close the flash files. That also we did. Then we did tools. Which tools we did? Line tool, pencil tool, rectangle, brush, paint bucket, eraser, text, selection, free transform tool, and then grouping and ungrouping of objects we did. What was the meaning of grouping? Grouping means to combine the basic shapes or objects together as one, and ungrouping means again separating them or again making them individual objects. So this was all in this chapter. Students, just go through this chapter, it's quite interesting, read it, and if any doubts you can ask me on the group. In the next video we will do the exercise and question answers of this chapter. That's all for today. Thank you.